The LG Optimus L5 II is a refresh on the company's 2012 Android mid-ranger, with a new processor, new OS, and new design. But is it a worthy update over the original? The first thing you notice with the L5 II is that it's light, extremely light in fact, at just 103 grams. In this instance, when paired to the fact that the bodywork is all plastic, including the chrome bezel and removable back, it creates a very cheap overall feel. The design is an improvement over its predecessor, with that dark chrome trim, a centrally mounted hardware home button which doubles as a multicoloured LED notification light, and programmable quick button on the phone's right side. Just as with the previous Optimus L5, the phone totes a 4-inch display, but with a higher resolution WVGA IPS LCD panel front and centre. A highlight of the device, the screen offers great viewing angles, accurate colours and clarity across both text and images. Blacks are its biggest weakness, whilst the most unusual quirk appears to be the lack of automatic brightness. The plastic covering the screen is also a magnet for fingerprints. LG has made sure that the Optimus L5 II feels current thanks to the inclusion of Android 4.1.2 Jelly Bean. The OS is pretty heavily skinned with LG's own Optimus UI, but the features it brings add a lot of customizability, as well as a few unique LG apps. Users can change wallpapers, app icon images and sizes, access a host of quick settings from the notifications bar, and program the phone's hard quick button to launch any installed app. With no front-facing camera, the L5 II's imaging prowess relies solely on its rear-facing 5-megapixel camera. Aside from the welcome addition of an LED flash, the resultant experience is pretty lackluster, with narrow dynamic range, poor colour reproduction and 360p standard definition video. Check the full review on Recombu.com to see the full offering of still and video samples to see what we're talking about. For a mid-ranger in 2013, we were a little sceptical at first regarding the L5 II's 1GHz single-core processor and 512MB of RAM. Out of the box, the UI turns out to be surprisingly snappy, but whilst navigating home screens remains fluid, after a little use, many other aspects of the phone begin to lose their polish. Switching between apps, accessing the notifications panel, and gaming can all result in lag and poor performance. With regards to the 1700mAh battery, it's a brighter story, with a single charge lasting a day and a morning. Alongside that battery, the phone's removable back also conceals a microSD slot, which you'll definitely need to use if you want to store any content beyond the 4GB of user-accessible storage built into the phone. It's hard to love the LG Optimus L5 II in the current smartphone market. On the surface, elements of the design and the UI feel premium and snappy, but dig down deeper and you'll find sluggish performance, an underwhelming camera and high price tag at around £189, SIM-free. We'd rather lay down our cash for one of the two affordable dual-core offerings in the form of the Nokia Lumia 520 or the 720p HD display-toting Acer Cloud Mobile S500.